Welcome to the Golden Trail World Series television show. We're here in, where are we, Martin?
Well, David, we are in Madeira Island for the final of the Golden Trail World Series.
What we're going to be doing each day is taking you through the highlights, the lowlights, the absolute heroes and the people who had shockers for the day. It's going to be packed full of footage, we've got interviews, and we've also got insight that you won't be able to get from the athletes other than at the bar.
And actually, one detail is that what you see above us is athletes of the stage. What does that mean?
So we've decided instead of just showing the people who've done well and won stages, we're actually going to highlight someone every day who's been, for us, the standout athlete of that day. It doesn't mean they've won. It means they've gone above and beyond anyone else.
In any direction.
Any direction.
Yeah. So, you know, we'll be talking about this. And so... this way, that way, it's opposite. But we'll have athletes of stage one right up there as soon as we hit it.
But what we're going to start with today is we're going to look at some highlights of what's been happening throughout the stages. It's going to show the men and the women from the elite level. And it's 10 minutes of full footage that's been edited to really get an insight into what it feels like and what the athletes have been through today.
Shall we?
Let's do it.
So I bet.
They're going to be coming up, and something to consider, we don't just have the race going on. There's actually segments as well. So throughout the day, runners will hit certain points of the trail. There'll be an uphill, a downhill, and a flat section where they have to run as fast as they can. So this is going to bring together all of that and hopefully give you an insight into what happened throughout the course. So can we run that footage, please, sir?
We said please. There we go.
I mean, look at this start line here. This is dry, for one.
I mean, yes, it was kind of dry right at sea level, at the bottom, all these world-class athletes, all the elites
look
who have
view.
Qualified.
I didn't get to the start. I didn't see that. I mean, that's a fast start, but compared to the rest of the races, in fact, we're cutting straight to Remy, and this is early on, and he's already by himself.
He actually left the field very, very quickly. And I mean, Remy is an uphill specialist and he wanted to make a statement this year. And only Elusine was actually decided to put on a massive effort and try to keep up with Remy, although he only caught up with Remy.
And look at the quality of climbers behind there. Robert Kemboy is an incredible climber.
Rueda.
And here goes Ali. She's her only slip of the day, it seems. So Ali led out. And I think the big surprise was El Hussein was with Remy. But Ali, she's had two races in America and she's not led out yet. And yet she comes here to Europe and she put in such a strong start.
And look at her. Like, she's just passing everyone, men's included. She was just so strong. And again, she explained that training on the Manitou ascent. Well, that's what she does. That's the steps.
And this is who she feared, Ninka. Now, Ninka's got quite a strong lead in this series. So she said she wasn't going to be coming out full throttle, but actually she didn't look as smooth as she normally does. Sarah and Bailey, of course, Sarah's going to be giving everything.
And so, and you might be wondering, because you saw a cast, you saw a big bandage, this is still the first stage. And yet, because of the season and how intense it was, some athletes are already coming in like slightly injured. But we'll get back to that later. This is Caitlin Fielder also chasing really, really strong in that uphill. And that's the plateau.
Look how effortless he is. He's
well,
just, but this,
they're working.
So this is actually part of a segment. And El Hussein was running the fastest of anyone on the course, even though he'd already buried himself on the uphill. You can see here all the other people we expect to be at the front. When Robert's being dropped on a flat section, that's surprising. Where is Manu there? It's not Manu. Where was Petro there? Because he actually started quite far back for how he went through the rest of the race. You can see Ali still pushing.
She was flying, and we were expecting Ninka to actually catch her on the flat.
Yeah.
And it never actually happened. At least on the beginning of that flat section, she was like, whoa, Ali's on a different level today.
But I don't think you can quite tell from this just how wet it was. There were huge puddles across the course. And people didn't expect it because it didn't look like clouds were coming in. Look at that finish line. It's insane.
That, I mean, that's the finish of the sprint section, to be fair. And
there we go.
These are the puddles you were talking about. I think they're going to go through it. And this is the sprint section, indeed, where Elhussein El Azawi took the fastest time today.
And I think people have forgotten that El Hussein is in this series because he couldn't travel to America because of visa. And look at this. He's responding so well.
Eli Hemming.
Eli Hemming, yeah. In fact, all three of them at the same point. That just shows, look at the slow. I mean, you can't talk over slow-mo. But Eli is someone who's quite new to the series. Tebow's never raced him before. Ali blew through this too. And then Ninka, who you'd expect to be running smoothly because of the cast and because she was nervous about falling, you can see she's not moving as fluidly as you expect for someone who's a 2:22 marathon runner.
Yeah. And here's Sophia Lockley as well. She was staying in third for the longest time and putting the actual best effort on this sprint segment.
And Sophia said earlier that she was quite disappointed with the uphill. She just didn't feel like she was herself. So it was quite surprising to see her run. Oh, Villaries.
She had a really tough day.
And look at this. This is Danny, who we expected second in the series to come out performing pretty well, but he raced last weekend, and you can tell, like, he actually looks good here.
Yeah, he looked pretty good. He was just doing his best, trying to keep up, but then he raced, indeed, like, a full marathon, actual 45 kilometers at Transvulcania, and then that was just too much for him.
And you can see Fillerite here. She's the only one who's actually wearing the jacket, and that, to me, says that she's not comfortable.
Mm.
Petru and Tebow together. Petru, people don't realize how good he is, actually, on technical and wet terrain. People know he's great at Sierras and now, but today he really started to shine as soon as he got to the top. And here comes Manu.
We're going to talk about him later. But he meant business, and you can see it on his face. He was waiting for that final downhill, and he was a little bit further back, but I mean,
that smoky intensity.
In that descent, that was incredible. He caught up three people and then got really close to another two. And then Ali here, still cruising in first place. And you guys will find out why she's holding onto her phone like this just a bit later.
And what people don't realize about Ali as well, at Flagstaff, she had the fastest time over the first 2K of technical. She's really improved in that. You can see here, this is a faster section of the course still, yet to hit the really solid downhill. And people look more comfortable than they have previously. Even Fillerice is starting to look like, you can see in her eyes, there's still a bit of nerves.
I mean, for a lot of those athletes, like, these kind of stage race is very new.
Yeah.
So actually going into it is like, well, how do I manage this?
Hello.
And there we go.
Elise there, she looked smooth this whole... In fact, Caitlin looks great here as well. Those two are the fastest descenders.
And then you're going to see Caitlin and Sarah work together and work against each other and with each other.
Yeah.
We'll see that later on the finish line. And here, Remy followed by Elhussein. And Elhussein was closing in. Actually, he passed Remy right before the last downhill. And then Petro and Thibaut still together, pushing hard on that flatter section.
I hadn't realized that Thibaut had stuck with Petro for so long,
yes,
which is super impressive given Petro's his flat out pace. And Rui, I wasn't sure what to expect from him today. He started faster than I thought, but he held on well.
I mean, he has a lot of potential. He's a very, very strong runner. It just depends on the day. Sometimes he performs really well, sometimes a little bit less, but it looks like he's found his rhythm, and hopefully he can keep that going for the week.
Here comes Elise. I mean, you're gonna find out later just how far she was, but she was saving herself for this downhill.
And here again, Sarah together with Caitlin.
And
that last downhill.
And Sarah has said before this race, she's fallen in three of the six Golden Trails so far. You can see she's strapped up from the last race. She does have a bit of unconfidence now in some of that downhill. And I think that is starting to affect her performances on days like today. Look at Petru.
And this is what not many people know. But if you're part of the old timers, you will all remember that descent from Petro against Kilian Jornet at Limone Extreme. And Petro actually beat Kilian at the end. So this shows
And look at this. This is not what people expect from trail, but this is why Madeira is so hard.
And look at the man. Look at this man.
And these steps, it's changed from steps to a bit of mud now, but you saw Eli in his first year hitting these, but These were super, super slippery. And if you didn't get your shoe selection right and you saw what the weather was like at the beginning, it really made a big difference. And
talking about shoe selection, look at all this is like going full send.
Wow.
Because
he's straight back up. Look at that, less than a second.
So we talked about the segments, and that's the downhill segment. And Anders has come to Madeira to score the fastest time in every single downhill.
And respect to the cameraman
he just went.
We've not actually seen this footage ourselves, just to let you know. So we're reacting to our
anxiety. And this is the fastest athlete in the women's category for the downhill, Elise Ponce. She knew she was strong, and she knew she had a lot to gain from going fast in that downhill because she was chasing at the time Sophia Locally to come in third place.
Look at
and
that.
Boom, he dropped the bomb. He did drop the bomb.
Remy said that he was coming out to win. I think he expected it. Incredible.
Elusine kept up, and then Petro Mamu came in third.
Look how fresh he looks.
Pretty strong.
Wow, super fresh.
And then there we go. Thibaut was happy because you will see right behind. Oh, actually, we missed that, but yeah. Manuel was just behind him, and so he just kept it at bay, but that was a really good finish for Thibaut. He was super happy.
And if you look back at previous Golden Trails, you can see that people aren't quite as ruined at the end. There's a bit more energy in everyone. People are being sensible.
Well, I mean, sensible, you'll see, because here, Ali finished really, really strong. And then, as you mentioned, Ninke wanted to take it easy. And then Elise Ponce finished strong on the descent, but she kind of managed. But here you go.
Look at the
this
gap.
This is.
Remember that gap for later, people. And here comes Sara. Look at the aggression.
So Caitlin Fielder was running ahead
until
she eventually took the wrong turn.
And look at this. Like, Sara is attacking. Caitlin had gone wrong, but they switched about two or three times until this point.
So Caitlin had come back to Sarah, but then Sarah is retaliating and then now passing her again.
And remember that the athletes,
and then boom!
The athletes don't actually know exactly where the finish line is because they've not raced this before. So they're running with a sense that it's close. They can hear noise.
And look at this, all the way until the end.
Wow.
That finish was insane. And then eventually,
she could almost put an elbow out. It's that close. That was 1/10 of a second. Sara stops her watch. Incredible. What I mean, that is the spirit of Golden Trail. That was for 3 points. Wow. Wow.
Yes, indeed, because we essentially see all these sprints finish because, you know, in a stage race, you play the time. But this is 5 races over 5 days. And so it's the ranking that gives the points, which in the very end will give the overall ranking. So that's why they're sprinting, because every position counts.
But at the end of the week, come back and watch this episode and just observe the different runners, because they're all running slightly different tactics. Not everyone's going to run every day. And so you'll be able to see who has buried themselves a bit more. And we've got a sense of it, but actually the other athletes don't even know yet who's going to start tomorrow and who's going to drive hard tomorrow, because some people are hobbling, but not everyone.
Oh, and all I can think is Manuel Mirias, who announces, like, I wish this was a 7 days race, because you're just like, the longer, the more people will be damaged, but I'll be fine.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we're going to hear from the winners now. So first up, I think we've got Ali, who surprised everyone, I think even herself. And we're going to hear exactly how she found today's race.
Let's hear it from her.
We started up and felt good, which you usually do the first like mile and then it sits in. But once we hit the stairs and we're at sea level, I just never really got that lactic feeling at all. Maybe a little on the downhill. But it was so cool because once we hit the stairs, which I train on a lot at the incline. That's something I like to do and I've done a lot of. And I just started kind of picking people off. I was in third for women and we were all kind of together. And so I kind of pulled away and then I was picking some guys off. And then rain rolled in and all the weather, lots of puddles at the top, spilled in one of them completely face down, which was annoying, but like then I was like, cool, this is what it is, like we're gonna have fun with this.
So my big question for you, did you expect that from Ali?
No, I did not. Especially, I mean, Am I getting ahead of myself trying to tell the story of what happened for to Ali the past 72 hours or so? Maybe I will hold off, but certainly not to answer your question. In short, I was not expecting that from her, especially because she said she would have a conservative approach. But we talked to her because we saw her in the stages in the US, and she was like, you know, I run by feel. And well, she must have been feeling pretty good today.
But this is our job. Like, we're paid to know these athletes and to understand them. And so to have the race, the Golden Trail, in her backyard, on her trail, and for her to not lead out, to not even podium, and yet she comes here and against Ninka, who is insanely fast, she's just, right, I forget what happened in the last two races, this is mine, and to lead from start to finish, just mind-blowing.
Yeah, and the fact that she says, like, okay, I'm just going to take it day by day, and I understand that some athletes might have hold back, and so, like, almost giving less credit to her, she was like, hey, you got 100 points today, that's in the bank, that's done. And so nobody can take that away from you, and she was like, yeah, we'll see.
And you can see from that interview, she's still bouncing. She's still little Tigger jumping around. So I think she's got more to come. But who else performed well?
And that we were expecting.
Remy, he said from the start, I'm here to win. I think I'm going to win. I'm going to try and win the first few days to make it easier and I control after that. But let's hear it from the man himself.
Yeah, I knew like before to come here that the shape was good, so I decided directly to take the lead from the gun and to show to the other that I was not here to controlling but to attacking and to make some points and maybe to skip the last stage if I have enough point to do it. But so I decided to like take the leads and push like really a good pace in the uphill to make some gap, and then in the flat I saw Elusin behind me, not so far, so I try to calm down a bit and like to drink and take a gel. And then when we go down, I saw that I was a bit faster than Elusin, so it gave me a bit of confidence. And then I keep pushing in the downhill, but I try to didn't take risk in the hard section. So I think I control it really well, and I hope tomorrow it will be quite the same.
So, Remy, after all, and that's actually the first thing he said to me crossing the finish line, like, I'm actually not that bad in the downhill after all.
It's weird. The trouble is, he's not the best of everyone in the world at the downhill. And so, because of that, and he's so good at uphill that people then assume, just like, by contrast,
skills don't match. So he's just like, oh, I'm not as good as downhill. But I mean, he held off Elusin.
Yeah. And but not just that. I've run with him the downhills the last 2 weeks filming him. And in Flagstaff, other than the very top, he was the fastest person on the whole downhill. And today, I'd say only Bart and Manuel were up at his pace, because I think he's got a belief now and he's backing himself. And people soon will stop remembering that he's good at uphill, because they're just like, he's pretty good all over.
Oh, I mean, this is an incredible end of the season for Remy, and he called it today. He said, I'm gonna go for the win, as you said, try to put some points in the bank. He did that in at the actual press conference, talking about today, and the question was asked, well, what about tomorrow? He's like, I'm gonna try to win as well.
Yeah, I think he will, but we'll find out. But first, we're actually gonna check out how people did in the segments. We've talked about Remy's up and down, but throughout the day we've had points like a Strava segment where anyone, including the national series, can run that section as fast as they can, and they win prizes every single day and towards an overall prize. But let's have a look. I mean, the first hill, Ali.
Yeah. And actually, after we talked about them, we talked about the segment to them, both Ali and Remy, who were the stage winner, and so went at just the fastest on that first climb, actually ended up being the fastest climber, but they actually didn't try to get that. So this shows how strong they were.
Yeah, and I'd say that the 1-2 of the females, I didn't expect. And in the men's, Roy, pretty good. Wasn't expected. Yes. I thought Danny would be up there more. Remy, absolutely. Elusin, he always starts fast.
Yes, he goes for it.
But let's see if we can see any of the footage.
Oh, yeah. Watch it.
I mean, He's so relaxed already. And what people don't realize, this doesn't look like a steep angle, but look at how much he's having to move his knees up because he's stepping such a big stride.
I mean, that segment was insane. And it was in the middle of a 6.5K for what was almost 1,500 meters of climb.
And look what Ali's holding. Ali's brought her whole, everything she owns at home to the race. she actually stopped to take some photos, genuinely.
She took two shots, yeah, during the uphill. So there you go. And then right behind Nienke Brinkman, Phil-Aris Kisang, and then in the men's, Elouzine Azawi, Rui Ueda. These are the top three best climber of this stage. Move on to the downhill.
Well, this is the one that excites me because you're good at uphill, great, well done. You're good at downhill, you've got to take some risks.
Oh, yeah.
And if we look at this, like what people don't realize about Elise is just how much better than everyone she is. Look at that time difference. It's like 90 seconds.
1:33 indeed. And this is on scene because if you look at the other segments, like the differences are like only a few seconds.
Now we're going to see some footage, but we're going to talk to you about Anders while we watch this footage. Because Anders came with the wrong shoes. There you go. There you go.
I mean, he went, oh.
Oh, it, wow. Wait. Can we watch that again?
Yeah, please, again.
This can we watch that again? Just look at how, it's almost like a judo roll. He's so used to falling that he's got his, oh, look at that. He's already just rolling onto his back.
Oh, and he hit his head.
He's transitioning back up. He fell 5 times. And what I didn't realize until I spoke to him afterwards, even before the end of the segment, he couldn't corner because his trainers and ran straight through. Now, look at the different style. He's attacking. Elise is just so smooth.
Smooth, like butter smooth, and just going into these really uneven steps. And it shows like how talented they are in this kind of technical terrain. But yeah, it is mind blowing. And the fact that Anders could actually take the win on that segment, knowing that he failed 5 times,
yeah,
and he said it earlier,
yeah,
like he actually went off course. He missed a turn, yeah, like about 10 meters from the end of the segment. So he had actually to drag himself back onto the trail and finish. So, I mean, the only thing I'm looking forward to for tomorrow is like more footage of this downhill,
yes,
segment.
Yes, and believe me, his times will be sensational. Now, moving on to the best sprinter. This actually at this stage of the race isn't as big a deal as it will be in the coming days, but I didn't expect El Hussein or Sophia to be up here. I genuinely thought Petru Mamu or maybe someone like Robert would, mm-hmm, be, mm-hmm, super fast, but I think the weather played a factor. And for me, I'm excited that Sophia won this because it suggests that she can still challenge for a win in the future races. But let's see how they look. Let's see how smooth they looked. And look at how much water. Look at him gritting his face.
He just had to like avoid getting so much rain in his.
And remember, El Hussein grew up in the deserts. This is as far from home as you could get. And I love the fact that he can run so fast when he's hating every minute. Sophia, by contrast, so smooth.
And cross-country skier, so she's used to like cold weather.
She doesn't look like she's working that hard, though. It just shows how impressive a runner she is. Her running style is
probably
just...
Probably got the right trajectories as well, avoiding the big puddles.
And there's some... I mean, there's not much more really to say about those sprints.
Well, I mean, yes, one thing I want to point out, because we talked to them, and both Sophia and Elouzine didn't actually see the start of the,
yeah,
segment.
Yeah.
They were just like working hard to try and move as fast as possible across that terrain. And when you look at the second place,
yeah,
both Nienke and Oscar are like respectively 0.01 of a second and then 0.09 of a second behind first place. So that was just so tight. So tight.
But if you enjoyed this today, actually tomorrow is where the real game begins with the segments,
yes,
because so, these are quite long segments. Most of them about a couple of K. And so... Is someone from the national series, is someone who is focusing just on these segments going to beat Remy? Probably not.
They should be able to make a difference on that.
But tomorrow, the sprint segment, 0.6 of a K.
Yeah. We talked about this before. I think tomorrow, like whoever really commits and focuses on the segments, they will get it.
We're going to see some new names, some new faces.
Ooh, yeah. Hopefully.
Some heroes will be made, but... let's go and look at the actual stage results. The what who came in the top 10. Now, looking at this, who surprises you on this list? Which positions? We've talked about Ali already, but anyone else there that you think?
I'm pretty excited and to see Julie Roux up there in the mix. Not surprising again with that descent to see Elise Poncet like really coming back and being strong. Caitlin as well, she's confirming because she had like not such a good performance at Pikes Peak after running CCC. She was a bit cooked, and well, she's right there and showed she had stamina, and she like we saw the finish with Sarah. It was just insane. So she's there, she's wanting to go as well. So mentally she's engaged.
And I think Fillory's as well. I mean, unfortunately, she got overtaken on the line by Caitlin and Sarah. So that was almost a fifth place finish. And actually, that's a great finish, given the circumstances and how hard she had to fight. And Elise said she was happy with seventh coming into this. So brilliant result. Let's see what that does to the overall.
Yes, so they scored all the points today. And now this is the overall ranking so far, after one stage that will define at the end of Sunday, the fifth stage, who will be the overall winners all the way from first to 10.
Big jump there for Elise. Everyone else is where we expect them, but you can see Ali's already in ninth. And if she carries on racing like that, she's going to be jumping up the table.
That's right, because Ali was actually in 14th place before today and then moved up to ninth. So she's now part of the top 10. She's in the mix. And again, yes, as you say, if she performs well, she can keep moving up. What?
Now, let's see what happened with the
names. Wait. There's one thing I actually want to mention, because we see names here like Maud Matisse, for example. She couldn't make it to the final. She chose not to. And therefore, according to the rules, and all the athletes were aware of that, if you don't come to the final, you will actually disappear from the overall ranking. So like tomorrow, we'll actually have an updated ranking, and we'll actually take out all those who will not make it to the final and therefore will not qualify for the overall ranking.
And even with that, the top 10, they're going to overtake them because there's 500 points.
Exactly. That's going to just keep moving. But just to make sure that everybody understands. All right, stage one for the men's.
Well, look at this. Firstly, what we haven't explained yet, Manu unfortunately ran with poles, left them at the top and didn't finish with them. And one of the rules that unfortunately has had to be enforced is that if you start with poles, you finish with poles. And that means he's lost his points for today. He will be back in tomorrow. But the big changes here for me are Manu down from third to 10th, and it's a different Manuel. I apologize. I've got this completely wrong. I'm talking about the overall rankings. Well, we've talked about today's results. For me, what's interesting is Bart is in sixth right now for today's finish. He was running a relaxed race.
He was in control. And more importantly, I think he finished happy. He finished with a smile. So it's like, okay, he delivered. He did what he wanted. Day one, check, and he'll just carry on. We've seen in the Azores and the last day, the Golden Trail Championship, he was really strong and consistent every single day. So we can expect him to keep hitting the top 10 and getting more and more points and moving up in the overall.
And let's look at the overall now, because as I was saying before, Manu's dropped to ninth. From third, Danny has dropped to seventh. Danny ended up 28th overall. He got 6 points. He could have stayed in bed, rested, and just be 6 point difference. He'd be in the same position in the table.
It is a difficult situation when you want to try your best, and then he had announced it. He's like, oh, I mean, the first day is going to be tough for me, so he's going to try. We saw him really down about his position from today and knowing the consequences. But, you know, that's what is. Again, and I really want to stress that, Manuel, that was an honest mistake. And we all felt sorry. Yeah. Like he, because we've seen him at OCC run with poles the whole freaking way. And that was not a problem for him. So when we actually announced to him the bad news, he was like, I didn't know. I should have known.
Yeah.
But because it's not a problem for me to carry the poles all the way through. So honest mistake, but you know, rules are rules and they have to be applied, and this is the consequences. But I know him enough to know that that's going to be enough to break him.
Yeah.
And he's going to come just with more of a vengeance, really wanting to score even more points and make a point.
But from our winners, we're actually going to highlight some people who are the athlete of the day.
That's what we talked about earlier.
Because we want to tell stories about people who haven't necessarily won, but I'm going to throw my hat into the ring. My athlete of the day.
All right, hit me.
Danny Marino.
That's a bold move. Would you like to? Would you care to explain the audience why you're choosing Danny Moreno?
We haven't seen any footage of Danny yet, and that's because Danny didn't get on the coach. So check the rules, and it turns out you don't race, you don't turn up. And so at the start line, most of the athletes were saying, where is Danny? Has she missed the bus? Has she missed the car? She didn't want to race every day. And so she's realized, why race everyone when they're fresh? So tomorrow, she's played the tactics. She's in their head. She's going to come out with fresh legs. And you can see how hard today was. I think it's a genius move. Absolute genius.
I mean, I have to say it, like, that was a really good move. And especially like seeing someone right from the gate go, use the strategic moves, be like, okay, you know what? Everybody's going to go through one stage, be tired, and then I'm coming in. And not saying anyone, because at the start, we're calling her, hey, you need to pick up your GPS tracker and all that. So, and she was like, yeah, no, that was my plan.
Yeah, brilliant.
Okay, I can appreciate that.
Who are you throwing into the ring?
For me, and that has nothing to do with the fact that she won the stage, but for me, 100%, Ally McLaughlin.
Okay. Obvious choice. Tell me why it's not.
Well, I think we have footage of her interview. Can we maybe use her word to actually explain the situation? Because I think she's been explaining kind of how the...
Well, we're having a bit of a technical problem, but...
So I will say, because I essentially carried the interview with her, and that's why maybe I was a little bit more moved by that. Ally McLaughlin is coming from the US. Hmm. And she started her trip to Madeira 3 days ago.
Ooh.
And she's gone through Toronto, and then her flight was delayed. And so she spent a night there. And then she did Toronto, London. Her flight was canceled, next flight. So she spent another night in London. She spent 3 days between airports, delayed, canceled flight. And then she arrived last night, like this morning at 2, because she got to the airport, but then she didn't have cash. She could withdraw money because somehow her credit card didn't work. So she got in a taxi and the guy was nice enough to say, okay, I'll come back tomorrow. You pay me tomorrow. So it was a massive shambles. So essentially she made it without her bag. Her bag didn't make it. And then she got to the hotel, to her room at 2 a.m., got up at 6 a.m. to get on the bus, pick up what was not even her number because it was messed up. And that's why you've seen on the images that she's running with the phone in her hand, because the phone was mandatory equipment. However, she did not have her pack, her running pack, where she actually could store her phone in. So regardless of all that, she got to the start and she was all smiles, like, I'm super excited to be here. She has the nicest attitude, where I believe some people could have used that to sandbag and be like, I'm not going to win or anything. No mention of that. She's like, I'm so happy to be here. And for that reason, that's why I nominated her.
Okay. I mean, Danny, I love you, but I think Ally wins.
Plus, it's hard to be like, met a woman of the day when they're actually not there.
True. Come on. Chalk it up. Athlete of the day. Where are we going? Ting, ting, ting. Boom, boom, boom.
There we go. Ally McLaughlin, ladies and gentlemen.
So we're now going to look at the... We've done the overall rankings, so we're now going to move on to next stage.
Oof. That's a goodie.
So tomorrow, they're all back out at it. And what we don't know yet is which athletes will tactically choose not to run and which athletes are going to be coasting. Because if you come fifth in... all five races, you get more points than if you win three. And similarly, if you come 10th in all five races, you get more points than if you come fifth in three. So the ability to run and run and run really is going to start to rack those points up. But
consistency will be key. Yeah.
But tomorrow, it's back out with... Oh, we can actually watch it.
Yes.
So again, starting from the city, starting low.
Start at sea level.
And I think what's key about this race is, if you look at it, there's three downhills.
Mm.
And it's hard to run a downhill anyway. It trashes your legs. But to then have to change your muscles again to run back up twice in a race is super tough. And they've put some of the segments quite early on. So even though Remy is confident that he's the fastest up these hills, in these shorter segments so early, he'd be a fool to risk going for that segment.
Yeah, and I don't think he will try that again. Hey, he announced it, and I got this one. I pushed it a little more.
But he's definitely going for the overall, and he's stated very clearly that he wanted to make another win to be safe and like ahead of the team. Like, look at this running on the ridges, and that's going to be super exposed. And then that crazy downhill, and obviously the downhill segment has been put right there.
And you saw how much not Elise, Elise was just flowing, but Anders was burying himself on that downhill. So he's hobbling today. Imagine what his legs are going to feel like by the bottom of that middle segment. And he's still got the biggest downhill to come.
He's going to be crawling home, but that doesn't matter to him. Like, he's coming for the downhill segment, and that's the only thing he's going to focus on.
And it's a late sprint stage. I mean, I'm going to have to film that. I don't know how I'm going to manage it, really.
Especially because he's so short. Like, they're going to go all out.
Imagine these athletes running as fast as they can, 650 meters. So you can see 1400 vertical climb, 26K. This is still a chunky race, and this is going to hurt.
Oh, yeah. Can't wait to see what happens tomorrow.
So what are your big things for me? I'd say who's going to turn up, who's going to go for the segments.
100%. And then again, I want to see, like, if already we start like seeing athletes showing signs of weakness, or the opposite, be like starting to creep up, and then every single day we'll be moving up in the rankings.
Well, we'll be back racing tomorrow at 9. We're going to be back with the live at 8 o'clock tomorrow night with all the highlights. So thanks for watching. Happy trails.
Yes, thank you so much for being here. And then we'll see you tomorrow, same time. Tune in and leave us your comments if you have any questions. By all means, we'll try to answer that.
Happy trails, people.
Well done, David.